Hey guys, it's Hannah, and today I'm going to be talking about the top 5 books I read this summer. So I've kind of been neglecting doing monthly reading wrap-ups just because I feel like I read such a different amount of books every single month that it ends up becoming kind of jarring. Like sometimes I will only read like 2 books, and sometimes I will read 10, and then they end up being like a lot of work, and sometimes I don't have enough to say, sometimes I have too much to say where I could just do a review instead. So doing wrap-ups every single month just isn't really my thing, but I have read a lot of really good books recently. And so I decided that I would just do like a summer reading wrap up where I tell you of all of the books that I read this summer, but I only go over like my favorite ones that I've read, so like my top 5 favorite ones. Reagan from Peru's Project used to do these videos where she'd talk about like the top 5 books that she read in a different season, and I took inspiration from that video because I think it's a really good idea, and I think doing it this way is going to be a lot easier for me, so that way I can tell you guys about all of the books that I read, but just kind of give you my detailed thoughts on my favorite ones. So I read a total of, I think, like 18 books this summer, 17 books or something like that, which is not as many as I had planned to read this summer, but I was in a pretty bad reading slump for a while. So it's not that bad considering how much I didn't want to read sometimes. So basically what I'm gonna do in this video is just go over every single book that I read this summer and then give you my star rating. And then at the very end, I'm gonna tell you which ones are my top 5 and tell you some more of my detailed thoughts on them and why I like them so much. I read a lot of really, really good books this summer. Like most of these are 4 and 5 star ratings, so narrowing it down to a top 5 was very hard. I considered making this like a top 10, but I didn't have exactly 10. I had more like 7. So it's gonna be top 5, but I also have a couple of honorary mentions. So without any further ado, let's get into all of the books that I read this summer. The first book I read this summer was The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas, which I gave a 5 out of 5 stars. The next book I read was Anne of Green Gables by L.M. Montgomery, which was for the Ostentatious Book Club, and I gave this one a 3 out of 5 stars. The next book I read was Lord of Shadows by Cassandra Clare, which I gave a 4.5 out of 5 stars, but I also have a full spoilery review for this book if you'd like to go and see my in-depth thoughts. I'll leave that linked on the screen as well as down below. This next book I read while I was traveling in Europe this summer, and that is Strange the Dreamer by Lainey Taylor, and I gave this book a 5 out of 5 stars. The next book I read this summer was Shadow of the Wind by Carlos Ruiz Zafón, and I gave this book a 5 out of 5 stars as well. Now we're getting into some of the Victoria Schwab that I read this summer, the first one being A Conjuring of Light by V.E. Schwab, and I gave this book a 5 out of 5 stars. Then after A Conjuring of Light, because I wanted some more Victoria Schwab, I read The Savage Song, and I gave this book a 4 out of 5 stars. Then we're getting into some of the books that I read during the readathons this summer, because there were 2 readathons that I participated in. One of them was Zoe's 24-hour readathon, and then the other one was the Booktubeathon. So I read quite a few books during those 2, and these first 3 are the ones that I read during the 24-hour readathon. The first one being Saga Volume 7 by Brian K. Vaughan and Fiona Staples, which I gave a 5 out of 5 stars. The next one was The Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue by Mackenzie Lee, which I gave a 5 out of 5 stars. Next, during the readathon, I read Vincent by Barbara Stoke, and I gave this one a 4 out of 5 stars. And then finally, I read the majority of Our Dark Duet during the 24-hour readathon, which I gave a 5 out of 5 stars. Next up was the Booktubeathon, which I read a total of 6 books during. The first 2 books being Smoke and Shadow Part 1 and Part 2, the Avatar the Last Airbender comics, which both got 4 stars. Oh, and I also read Part 3 after the readathon, which I also gave 4 stars. Next, I finished Eliza and Her Monsters by Francesca Zappia, which I gave a 5 out of 5 stars. Next, I read We Are Okay by Nina LaCour, which I gave a 3.5 out of 5 stars. The next book I read was History Is All You Left Me by Adam Silvera, and I gave this book a 4 out of 5 stars. And finally, the very last book that I read was No Matter the Wreckage by Sarah Kay, which I gave a 5 out of 5 stars. But that is it for all of the books that I read during this summer. As you can see, I very much enjoyed a lot of them, pretty much all of them. There isn't one that I gave less than like a 3-star rating, and I still enjoyed the 3-star ones as well. So it was a really great summer. But before we get into my top 5 favorites and more of my thoughts on those, I just want to give like a couple of honorary mentions to like a few of them that didn't make it into my top 5, but I still really love them and I have a couple things to say. First honorary mention has to go to The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas. I absolutely adored this book. It's such a powerful and moving story. It's inspired by the Black Lives Matter movement, and it's just something that I think you will learn so much from if you read it, no matter how much you already know. It makes you think critically, and it really opens your eyes to a lot of things that you may not have considered before, and I'm just so happy that this book exists and is doing so well right now. It's hands down one of the best 2017 releases I have read this year, and I just cannot wait for the movie to come out, and I can't wait for more from Angie Thomas because I will pick up anything she writes. And my second honorary mention has to go to A Conjuring of Light by V.E. V.E. Schwab. I am such a huge fan of Victoria Schwab, and I absolutely love the Darker Shade of Magic trilogy. I put off reading this book for so, so long. It came out in like February or something, but I didn't read it until this summer because I was just so afraid of the series ending. But I'm so happy that I read it because I absolutely loved it and it was the perfect conclusion. I'm so in love with all of these characters. I love the way that they progress over the three books, and I love this world, and I just want everyone to read this series. So if you haven't picked it up yet, I highly recommend that you do. All right, so that is it for my two honorary mentions. And now let's get into the top five books that I read this summer that I'm so in love with. And all of them are kind of on my list of like all-time favorites now because that's how good they were. The first book I want to talk about is The Shadow of the Wind by Carlos Ruiz Zafón. I feel like I haven't talked about this book at all on my channel yet. I didn't even mention that I was reading it on here. I talked about it on Twitter a little bit, but not on here. So I'm really happy to finally be talking about this book. This book is like a historical fiction mystery thriller. It takes place in Spain over the span of several years from about 1919, I believe, to like 1950. I don't fully remember, but it spans over a couple of world wars and it follows the story of this boy named Daniel, whose father one day takes him to this library called the Cemetery of Forgotten Books. And he asks Daniel to pick a book from that library to keep with him and treasure. So when Daniel picks a book, he ends up picking a copy of the book, The Shadow of the Wind by the author Julián Carax. And he becomes fascinated with this book after he reads it and he's so in love with it and he wants to read everything else this author has ever written. Only to find out that this is pretty much the only copy of that book in existence, and basically everything else Julián Carax has ever written has been destroyed, and someone has just been going around destroying the entirety of his work and no one really knows why. And Daniel becomes kind of obsessed with Carax's books and Carax's life, and he wants to know more about him. So it spans over like the next 8 years as Daniel kind of does some investigating to figure out what happened to Julián Carax and why his books are being destroyed. And this book is just so, so incredible. I actually went into this expecting something very, very different. For whatever reason, I was under the impression that this book was magical realism, and it is not. It is not magical realism. There's nothing magical in this book at all. I think I just heard Cemetery of Forgotten Books, which sounds really magical. So do not go into this book like me thinking that it's magical realism, because it is not. It is a historical fiction mystery thriller. It takes place during a war. It deals with torture, there's rape, there's abuse, there's like a lot of traumatic stuff in here. So trigger warnings for any of that if you're not comfortable reading it, because I was completely unaware of that before going into this book. And it would have been nice to have a little bit of a warning, so I'm just giving that to you now. But despite that, it is truly one of the best books I have ever read. People have been telling me to read this book for like the last 2 years, and I finally listened and finally read it, and I couldn't be happier. It's just so well written. The writing is exceptional. The storytelling itself, like the arc of the entire story, is so well crafted. The characters are extremely complex, very, very flawed, and so human. And I love the historical context of it and the commentary that it makes on war and humanity and just so many things. It's just so, so good. That's all I can say. So if you've yet to pick this book up and you're putting it off like I have always been, or if you've never heard of it before and the synopsis intrigues you, I highly, highly recommend picking it up because genuinely, it's a new favorite of mine and I already want to reread it. The next favorite that I read this summer is Strange the Dreamer by Lainey Taylor. Before I even went into this book, I already knew that it was going to be one of my favorites because I love the Daughter of Smoke and Bone trilogy. It's one of my favorite trilogies and I just love Lainey Taylor's writing. So I was already so hyped for this book. And then after reading it, I just fell even more in love with it because it wasn't what I was expecting and it was so much better. This book is a bit complicated to explain, but it takes place in this fantasy world where we follow our main character named Laszlo Strange. And Laszlo is a librarian and he's basically like a keeper of books in this city that he lives in. And he's always been fascinated with the forgotten city of Weep. Weep is essentially, as the name suggests, a city that has been forgotten throughout time and history and it's kind of been erased from people's minds. And it's called the Forgotten City or the City of Weep because no one actually remembers the real name of the city. Even the people who are from the City of Weep don't remember the name. But his entire life, Laszlo has been fascinated by this Forgotten City and he studied it a lot. And that's really all I like to say about the synopsis of this book because there's so much more to this, but I feel like saying anything else gives things away. So all that you really need to know is that it follows Laszlo and his love for this forgotten city, and then the story progresses and the characters go on some adventures, and then there are monsters, there are gods, there are demons, there's just like everything, magic. It's beautiful and I love it so much. This is a YA fantasy, but to me it reads a lot more like an adult fantasy because of the complexity of the world. It's far more in depth than a lot of YA fantasy tends to go into, and because of how political it gets at times, there's just something about it that feels more like the high fantasy that I've read in adult than it does like the YA high fantasy that I've read. But nonetheless, I think that even makes it more of a perfect kind of fantasy read, because if you kind of want to get into some more adult fantasy, I definitely recommend trying this one out, because it's very close to a lot of adult fantasy. But yeah, I just cannot recommend this book enough. If you like fantasy, if you like magic, if you like anything fantastical at all, then I am sure that you will enjoy this book, and I cannot wait for the second one to come out because that cliffhanger was too much for my heart and I need more. The next favorite that I want to talk about is The Gentleman's Guide to Vice and Virtue by Mackenzie Lee. This book is so good. This book is a YA historical fiction novel that follows the story of this white aristocratic boy named Monty, who is doing kind of whatever he wants in life because he's wealthy and privileged and doesn't really have anything holding him back very much. But the one thing that is kind of holding him back, because it's affecting his heart, is the fact that he's in love with his best friend Percy. Monty's bisexual, so he's been with girls and he's been with guys, but he has never loved anyone the way that he loves his best friend Percy. And the story follows Monty, Percy, and Monty's younger sister Felicity as they all go on kind of like a road trip throughout Europe as a summer trip before they all go off to school. And on this trip, they tend to get into a lot of trouble. This story is just so, so fantastic, and it is truly one of the funniest books I have ever read in my entire life. The thing is, the book deals with a lot of heavier topics because Monty being bisexual and Percy being half black are things that are not exactly considered the norm during the 1700s in England. So I definitely say be aware of those things before going into it, but it does not deal with those things lightly. It actually tackles the topics, but it still incorporates humor in such an exceptional way. I have truly never laughed more in any other book in my entire life because the writing in this book is just so, so good, and it's so witty and smart and everything that I love. Monty is like the most dramatic character I have ever read about in my entire life, and it's hysterical because I relate to him so many times. There are so many things that he says and I'm like, yes, that is literally me, that is what I feel all the time. And it's truly unlike any other book I've ever read before. It's so fresh and so new and so well done, and I'm so, so happy I read it. I've also heard that there's going to be a sequel to this book that is about Felicity, his sister, which sounds so great because it has to do with pirates, and like, I am so, so excited for this. So yeah, if you have not picked up A Gentleman's Guide yet, I highly, highly recommend that you do. It's one of my all-time favorite books now. It's just so good and so hysterical, and I promise you will not be able to put it down. The next book that I have here that's a favorite kind of took me by surprise, and I sobbed so much, and I did not expect to cry this much, but let me tell you, it was a mess. And that book is Our Dark Duet by V.E. Schwab. This is the second book in the Monsters of Verity duology right after this Savage Song, and I enjoyed this Savage Song. I gave it a 4 out of 5 stars, but Our Dark Duet just tore my heart to pieces. The minute I finished this book, I went on Twitter and just like started yelling because I was not okay. Like, I have still yet to recover from the end of this book. It was so much. Somehow, even though what happens in this book is everything I didn't want, Victoria Schwab somehow convinced me that it was what I wanted. Like, it ended and I was devastated and I was like, this can't be happening. Like, I can't accept this. And then like, you think about it for a little bit and I'm like, but it was perfect. Like, it was just the perfect ending. It couldn't have ended any other way. Like, it's just so exceptional. I love all of the relationships in this book. I love all of the characters. I loved that she included a non-binary character, which is something that you very rarely get to see in YA fantasy. And I just love everything about this book. It's just so good. I don't know how to express that. I really kind of just want to do like a full-on spoilery review of this just so I can like gush and cry with you all, but I also know that that video would just be a mess because it would literally just be me crying. All I will say is that I love August and I love Kate so much, and they're my everything, my precious children, and I just want happiness for them forever. That's it. And finally, the very last book on my list of top five favorites I read this summer is Eliza and Her Monsters by Francesca Zappia. I've talked about this book quite a few times now on my channel, but it follows the story of this girl named Eliza who has a webcomic that is very, very popular on the internet. So popular that she has like millions of readers and there are people who write fan fiction based off of her webcomic. And one day, this boy moves to her school who she then finds out is actually the most popular fan fiction writer of her webcomic. But then problems arise when she finds out who he is, but he does not know who she is, and she has to deal with this. Eliza also has anxiety, and that's something that she deals with day to day. And for me personally, as someone who has anxiety, that was one of my favorite aspects of this book overall because it was just so relatable for me. But apart from that, the story itself was just so well written and so heartbreaking and heartwarming at the same time. It was just extremely real and it had everything that I love in a contemporary. It dealt with a lot of very real human topics in a very real and human way, and it made the characters come to life and I could empathize with them and feel and experience everything they were going through. This has truly become one of my all-time favorite books because of how much I could relate to it and just how well written it was. And the thing was, I expected to like this book, but I never expected to fall so in love with this story, and I'm just so happy that it took me by surprise like that and that I can now call it one of my all-time favorites. But that wraps it up for all of the books that I read this summer and my top five favorite ones. Like I said, I enjoyed everything that I read this summer. All of these books were just so good, but these top five just blew me away and I'm so happy that I finally read them and that I can now treasure them so dearly. Let me know in the comments down below what your favorite book was that you read this summer, or if you read any of the same books that I did, let me know any of your thoughts on them as well. But if you'd like to follow me on any of my social media, all of my links are in the description box as always. But thank you all so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in my next video. Bye!